and body discomfort during simulated driving.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Nathan, and I will be representing my group in presenting our findings of our study investigating the impacts of bilateral armrests on spinal muscle activity, spinal loading, and body discomfort. This is the outline of our presentation. Professional drivers, for example taxi drivers, are subjected to prolonged driving of more than 4 hours throughout the course of their shifts. This has been found to result in muscle fatigue, increase in spinal loading and body discomfort, and therefore increasing their risk of developing low back pain. A 15-minute drive has been found to increase muscle fatigue, increase EMG amplitude of the upper trapezius and deltoids by an alarming 100%. This causes a reduced blood flow to the muscles, resulting in the accumulation of metabolites and hence causing fatigue. A predominantly flexed posture has been found to result in the posterior pelvic rotation, which decreases lumbar lordosis and increases the load on the intervertebral disc, and thereby increasing the spinal load by approximately 33%. An increase in the mean ischial pressure from prolonged sitting of more than 4 hours leads to reduced blood flow to the back muscles, which also increases body discomfort. Research on automobile ergonomics has investigated the changing of backrest inclination angles, seat pad orientation, and lumbar support in an attempt to find the optimal vehicle seat. However, to date, there's limited research performed on the usage of bilateral armrests and its effects on the low back muscle activity, spinal load, and body discomfort in the automobile setting. Previous research on armrest usage in wheelchairs has found to reduce EMG readings of posture muscles and upper trapezius muscles. Research on office chairs has found armrests to aid in reducing upper trapezius activity by 57% after an hour of office work. Armrests have also been found to aid in reducing lumbar disc pressure as compared to arms hanging. This is illustrated by the graph that despite the different degrees of backrest inclination, this pressure measure is consistently lower for subjects using armrests. Therefore, the purpose of our study is to investigate muscle activation patterns, spinal loading, and driver comfort levels with the usage of bilateral armrests in the automobile setting during simulated driving. To the best of our knowledge, there's been no such study done. So the addition of bilateral armrests in cars may potentially influence the future designs of car seats and aid in reducing low back pain in professional drivers. We hypothesize that the usage of bilateral armrests will result in a lower muscle activity of the erector spinae and the multifidus, a lower spinal load, as well as lower body discomfort as compared to not using armrests. Next, I'll be going through the flow and the methods of our study. 30 subjects were assessed for eligibility. However, 18 subjects were excluded due to failing of inclusion and exclusion criteria, a refusal to participate in the study, as well as error in data collection of 4 subjects. Prospective subjects were excluded if they have low back pain, spinal malalignments such as scoliosis, past injury or surgery to the back, as well as any other medical conditions. Therefore, at the end of data collection, 6 sets of results from each group were analyzed. 12 subjects were randomized into either the control group or the experimental group. The control group, as shown in the picture on your left, drove continuously for 1 hour without armrests, while the experimental group drove with bilateral armrests, as shown in the picture on the right. During the collection of the results itself, baseline measurements of height and weight were first taken. Maximum voluntary contraction was then done for the normalization of EMG readings. At 0 minute, 30 seconds of root mean square for EMG, the average and peak pressure for pressure interface, and BPD scores were collected. The subjects were instructed to drive as they normally would and to find the best position of comfort. At the 1 hour mark, data for the outcome measures were sampled again. At the end of the study, the subjects were taught stretching exercises with a leaflet from the Health Promotion Board. As mentioned earlier, the three key areas we are investigating are muscle activity, pressure interface, and body discomfort. And I will briefly go through the three outcome measures involved. For the first outcome measure, EMG, we investigated the muscle activity in the lumbar erector spinae and body fetus, and the electrodes were placed according to the recommendations of SENIAM, a European group dedicated to the study of to research in the area of surface electromyography. Shown above are the recommended locations for the two muscles investigated in our study, and the resulting electrode placement on the subject is shown above. Our next outcome measure is pressure interface. A pressure mat was placed on the seat. The data will be presented as a pressure distribution, with the data readings for average and peak pressure to be used for analysis. And finally, body part discomfort was assessed by a 10-point body part discomfort score sheet, which was sent out to the subjects before and after the drive. Next, Alicia will continue with the analysis of our results.
Thank you, Nathan. The statistical test chosen for analysis for all our outcome measures was the Man Within You test. Next, I'll be presenting on the findings from our research. A baseline analysis conducted reflected that there was no statistical difference between the control experimental groups for all our outcome measures. For SEMG, the average values at the 60th minute were subjected to statistical analysis. With significance set at p less than 0.05, no significant difference was found between the control and experimental groups. Despite the lack of statistical significance, we found a difference in the median between both groups. As seen here, the usage of bilateral armrests resulted in 70% lesser muscle activity for erector spinae and 78% lower muscle activity for multifidus than a group without armrests at the hour mark. This finding reflects that after an hour of driving, bilateral armrests aided in easing some load off the muscles. This reduction in muscle activity may be indicative of a delay in the onset of muscle fatigue after a prolonged drive. Further analysis performed on the EMG findings of each individual muscle revealed a significant difference for the left-sided muscles, as reflected by the p-values. This highlights that armrests resulted in lower muscle activity in the experimental group than the control group for the left erector spinae and multifidus. A possible explanation for this significant finding is due to the nature of the circuit, which mainly involves left turns. This increase in muscle activity is likely due to a higher loading on the left-sided muscles of turning. Hence, this further emphasizes the need for the usage of bilateral armrests as opposed to a unilateral armrest. To find the position of comfort, drivers tend to utilize the door on the driver's side as a makeshift armrest. This facilitates an asymmetrical posture, which causes unequal loading and strain on the driver's arms, shoulder, and back. Our finding gives credence to the usage of bilateral armrests, which helps reduce unequal loading and strain by promoting equal distribution of load on the back muscles. Moving on, let us take a look at the results collected from the pressure interface. The p-values for the average and peak pressure reflected no significant difference between the control experimental groups. Research in wheelchair found that armrests aided in the reduction of both average and peak pressures. However, it's important to note that these settings involve static upper body postures. In contrast, driving involves dynamic, continuous movements of the arms. Hence, this does not allow the full upper body weight to be supported on the armrest, which can explain for our lack of significant findings. As for BPD, the scores for all body parts did not reflect any significant difference between both groups, as seen by the p-values. In spite of this, our group found that median BPD scores for the neck is 57.1% lower, and that of the left shoulder to be 100% lower in the experimental group. This reflects an increased comfort level of the experimental group post 1 hour of driving, particularly in the neck and left shoulder. As armrests have been found to support the upper body, it can explain why bilateral armrests appear to provide more comfort in the upper body than that of the lower back. To evaluate the clinical significance of our research, it will be good to weigh the pros and cons of the usage of bilateral armrests in an automobile setting. The main disadvantage with the installation of armrests is the high cost associated. Our research has found that bilateral armrests reduce muscle activation, spinal load, and body discomfort by providing adequate support, potentially reducing the risk of low back pain after a prolonged drive. Given that the back pay incurs substantial economic losses to both the individual and community. The cost associated to instant armrest can be viewed as a worthy investment. Here are some limitations of our study. Future research conducted should attempt to perform a real-time analysis of road driving over the course of a taxi driver's shift. Since hot body vibration is one of the major components that may contribute to low back pain, it will be beneficial to investigate muscle activity, pressure, and discomfort skills under this condition. Besides this, the effects of bilateral armrest on the muscle activity of the upper body should be investigated, considering that our BPD results have shown that armrests are likely to benefit the upper body as well. In addition, given that our research is an explorative study and promising findings have been obtained, a larger sample size can be utilized in the future. In conclusion, armrests aid in the reduction of muscle activity and body discomfort after an hour of simulated drive. Hence, we advocate the use of bilateral armrests in an automobile setup. Bilateral armrests have also been found to result in lower muscle activity as compared to the control group for both erector spinae and multifidus, giving credence to the usage of armrests in lowering muscle fatigue with prolonged driving. Furthermore, armrests significantly decrease the activity of back muscles on the side, which was subjected to a greater load. This further emphasizes the importance of using bilateral armrests as opposed to unilateral armrests in an automobile setup. The high prevalence of low back pain in drivers indicate that more quality research should be conducted to address the occupational hazards associated with driving. In light of our findings, more research should be conducted to investigate the potentially beneficial role of bilateral armrests in decreasing the risk of low back pain in drivers. With this, we have come to the end of our presentation. Thank you.